A powerful new documentary shedding light on the injustices faced by transgender inmates in the United States, making its South Florida debut. It's called Where Justice Ends. It's premiering at the Outshine Film Festival tonight. Director George Zuber joins Nikki in studio to tell us all about this film.
George, welcome.
And thank you for having me.
Your second film that deals with issues affecting transgender people. You know, we've seen so much. Tell us about the film. Tell us why you decided to do this movie and what the film is about.
Well, the first film I did was a film called Just Gender, and it just explored the breadth and diversity of what it means to be transgender. During the course of making that film, I learned about the plight that many transgender people experience when they encounter the justice system here in the United States. And that became the genesis for the film.
And this film deals with how they're treated in prison. We've heard so much about the country, about which bathroom do they go to. When they go to prison, they have to deal with so much more.
It's very different than what you might see, for instance, on dramas on TV, Orange is the New Black, where there's a transgender woman housed with other women. But in reality, most transgender people are housed based on their genitals, and because most transgender people can't afford to do gender-confirming surgery, they find themselves in prisons where they don't necessarily belong.
So they may identify as a woman, look like a woman, but end up in a prison with men, and that puts them at risk for so much.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You also explore in this film that, you know, they may be in the process of transitioning, and then their medicines are stopped. What is the challenge there? Because then a lot of people say, well, does the prison system pay for it? What happens?
Well, people sometimes don't understand that hormones are very strong drugs. And if your body is acclimated to hormone, taking those hormones away abruptly is disastrous, not only physically, but mentally.
Mm-hmm. What kind of stories have you heard from individuals? Like, tell me about the people you profile in this film.
Well, we interviewed probably close to 36 people for this film. Of course, because it's a relatively short film, we can only include a fraction of those. But some of the people that come to my mind would include Ashley Diamond, who in Rome, Georgia, was arrested for pawning a miter saw and then found herself sentenced in prison for 12 years.
Wow. So it meant very severe. We look forward to seeing it. Where can you see it? Well, we have information up for you. It's part of the Outshine Film Festival. You can see it later today at the Regal Cinemas South Beach, located on Lincoln Road. And tomorrow, you say, in Fort Lauderdale.
Monday in Fort Lauderdale, 6:30 at the Gateway.
All right. Gary Zuber,
thank you
so much.